Today on Cross Chop, we're taking a look at the games I wish I didn't buy. For a lot of game collectors, it seems like many of us begin our collecting hobby by purchasing almost every game we can get our hands on. I know I certainly started off with this approach, but I don't necessarily regret my unfocused phase, because it actually exposed me to a lot of games and systems that I wasn't particularly familiar with. Nevertheless, I eventually narrowed my collecting focus to target Super Nintendo, Nintendo 64, and GameCube games, almost exclusively. I definitely still want certain games, and I keep a list and will buy them from time to time, but I do so much less frequently or haphazardly than I used to. I'm sharing all this because my selection process would have been different a year or two ago when I had more games. I've downsized my collection a little bit to sell off some of the games that I've beaten and knew I wouldn't play again, as well as some of the shovelware and shelf filler that I just didn't want taking up space in my game room. I guess this essentially means that the games I regret the most are the ones that I bought cheaply, never played, and then sold off, but that would make for a very interesting video, would it? So, in light of all that, here are the first video games that come to mind that I wish I'd never bought.
Number one, Agony.
This one was such a bummer. I had learned about this game being in development a year or two before its release, and I even included it in my list of most anticipated games of 2018. When it finally had its release date, I pre-ordered it for $40 and could not wait to play it. Unfortunately, when the game released and the reviews rolled in, the writing was on the wall. Concerned, but still determined to give it a fair shot, I got my copy from Amazon, installed it, and started playing. The reviewers were right. Every element of this game was average at best. More frequently, it carried the appeal of fluorescent excrement. The controls were functional, but exploration and enemy encounters were never fun or interesting. The game world was so unappealing and numbing to look at that any concern I had for the narrative evaporated within the first 30 minutes. Despite all of this, I actually did complete a full playthrough of Agony. I guess I felt determined to make sure that the game really was as bad as it seemed, and I'll unfortunately never get those hours of my life back.
Number two, Dragon Ball FighterZ.
This one I'm sure will exasperate some of you, but yeah, Dragon Ball FighterZ. Don't get me wrong, it's a terrific looking game, the combat systems are top notch, and from what I hear, it has an excellent story mode. I simply wish I hadn't bought it at full price on Switch when I did. Although this game had been out for much of 2018 on PC, PS4, and Xbox One, and could be purchased at a much lower price, I determined that I wanted it on Switch for the handheld functionality. I imagined that I'd be playing the game for weeks, learning all the character combos, gobbling up the story, and battling my friends online. What really happened was that I played the game for a weekend, had some fun for like 2 hours, and came to the realization that the game would not be worth $60 to me. For a while, I told myself, I'll come back to it, and I should give it another chance. But after a few months had passed and neither of those things had happened, I decided to cut my losses and traded it in with another game for my copy of the Resident Evil 2 remake. I'm sorry, DB FighterZ. It just wasn't meant to be.
Number three, physical copies of Telltale games.
This entry on my list really should have been a preventable no-brainer after I played The Walking Dead Season 1 for the first time back in 2013. I loved that game so much that I played it on my iPad, PS3, and eventually my PS Vita. From there, I visited some of Telltale's back catalog, including Jurassic Park the game, Back to the Future the game, Tales of Monkey Island, and thankfully, I purchased them digitally for, I think, less than $5 a piece. Later, however, I found myself buying a lot of PS4 games that I thought I wanted to keep handy in my collection. In this state of mind, there were occasional visits to GameStop, Target, and other game stores where I'd buy two or three games to take advantage of a buy two, get one free coupon or promotion. That's how I wound up with physical copies of Telltale's The Walking Dead Season 2, Batman, Game of Thrones, Walking Dead A New Frontier, and sadly, The Walking Dead Season 1 on Vita. Now, I want to be clear. I really enjoyed playing each of these games. The episodic adventure game format can be really fun, and Telltale pumped out a ton of solid licensed games for many years. I simply wish I hadn't bought physical versions to play one time, put on my shelf, and have no intention of playing again. All the Telltale games I once possessed are now long gone, probably under lock and key in a warehouse somewhere in Texas, along with my dignity.
Number four, Gemfire.
Ah, the first and only retro game on this list. As you can see, I still own Gemfire, despite my regretful purchase of it. I bought this game at Vintage Stock here in Missouri just over 3 years ago, in March of 2017. By this point in time, I had committed to my newfound focus on Super Nintendo, N64, and GameCube games. So when I spotted this box in the store, I thought it would make a great addition to my SNES collection. As it turned out, the game was not as complete as I'd hoped it might be, but it did have this cardboard insert inside. The cart's in really good shape, and it's got some cool Blockbuster stickering on the back here, as well as on the back of the box. And it also included this little insert, which is a substitution for the manual that I assume Blockbuster put in there. I bought this copy for $50, ignoring the fact that I really never play tactical turn-based strategy games, and hoping against hope that I might turn a new leaf and really enjoy playing this one. Well, I didn't, and now Gemfire really is merely a collector's item for me. To its credit, I've read that there is a devoted fan base for this game, and I really do think that this front box art looks super rad. Still, this is one I wish I'd skipped, either until I could find it cheaper, or forever.
Number 5, Mass Effect Andromeda.
Oof. Talk about another letdown. This game is the most recent entry on this list in terms of video games I've played, and it's the most emotionally disappointing too. Like so many of us who played the Mass Effect trilogy, I had really high hopes for this new story set in the franchise's universe. I actually installed this game just this week to try it out for the first time, and I was completely caught off guard by how bored I was. The characters and their dialogue came off as shockingly generic to me. And I wasn't enjoying the combat or the planetary exploration much either. It had been a long time since a sci-fi action game had made me want to go to bed more than continue playing, but there I was. I obviously have not sold this game or traded it in yet, and in all fairness, I do want to give this another shot just to make sure and see if it gets any better. But so far, the $12.58 I spent to buy this a few years ago feels like a total loss.
Number 6. Most of the limited run games I used to buy.
To be clear, this is not at all a dig at Limited Run Games as a company. I actually love that they and a number of other small companies are creating physical versions of digital-only titles and growing the checklists of PlayStation and Switch collectors everywhere. That said, I wish I had not bought the majority of limited run releases that I used to own when I did. I never bought any of the big box sets or even kept pace with the majority of games they put out. But I still dropped hundreds of dollars on games that, if I really wanted to play them, could have been experienced for much less than the $25 to $40 plus price tag of those individual titles. Today, I still have 12 limited run releases in my collection, which is down from the 26 or so that I used to have. I've already played some of these, and some of them I've not even opened yet, but these are the ones that I still want to play, to continue playing, or to collect, actually keep in my PS4 collection for now. But there's still a possibility that I'll offload a few of them in the future eventually too. All right guys, those are the games I wish I hadn't bought, and I hope you delighted in my anguish. Leave a comment below telling me what your most regrettable game purchase is, and if this was your first CrossChop video and you liked what you saw, please leave me a thumbs up and please subscribe. Thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and play heavy. Subsiding eternity.